One ballpark day at the summer.
Your own dick.
Hey, coach, are you sure you want Jess in now? I mean, we're down by 3 runs, and he's not exactly our best coach.
Come on. Let's rally up. Just give me your best.
What a lousy way to end the season. That little rally, killing our loser.
Come on, Zach, it's only fair.
I don't want fair. I want a loser. And instead, our season's going down the tubes. Next year, we gotta get a real loser.
Strike one.
Oh, what?
Inside Mobile Mission Command.
You know, I cannot believe the boldness of the cheater.
Yeah, he's a crafty one. You know, if he would just apply himself toward true craft the way he does toward deceit.
But Matthew 10:26 says, everything that is seen will be hidden. Everything that is known will be made hidden. And that includes your traps, cheater. Lord, please expose these snares of the enemy.
Watch this, boys. I'm sending test answers and kids to kids everywhere. Airmail! They'll never have to work for kids again!
That won't fly. Not in the light of Romans 12:17. It says, everyone try to fly.
Everyone includes teachers, principals, and classmates. Sorry, fellas. No more time for shooting the breeze. Gotta pass out some kids.
Psalm 135.
I don't believe I know that one.
Sure you do. You just don't like it. I know that the Lord is great. Our Lord is greater than all the flies. He sends the lightning with the flies. Colossians chapter 3, verse 23 says, in all the work you are doing, work the best you can. Work as if you are working for the Lord, not for the Lord. See, there's a reason it's called. Colossians chapter 3, verse 23.
You haven't seen the last of me, Bible man!
Maybe not, but this time, you failed.
I guess that old saying is true. Cheaters never cheat,
but God's people do.
Those who love God's teaching prosper. Everything they do will succeed.
Thanks. From Psalm 1.
Yeah. You know, still can't believe this place.
I know. We've been given the very first mobile mission command center. Can't believe it. I mean, it's humbling to think that Command Central entrusted all of this to us. Can't believe it.
And it's a lot of responsibility. I mean, it's like it says in Luke 12, verse 48, everyone who's given much will be responsible for much.
And we've been given a lot. Can't believe it. All the latest technology and tactical equipment. Can't believe it. Except one thing's missing.
Eunice.
Eunice, yeah. Can't believe it. Now, I wish they'd hurry up and get her with that circuit board upgrade. It's been pretty quiet around here without her online. I know it's only been 2 days, but... Intruder? Can't believe it.
Welcome.
I'm Josh Carpenter, and this is Josh Carpenter.
So how is she enjoying her special assignment at Command Central? I mean, we really miss working with her around here.
Oh, she loves it. It's an incredible blessing.
Yeah, I'll bet.
She has amazing opportunities to study God's Word while remaining on active duty with the Bible Adventure Team.
Yeah, I'll bet.
Good for her.
When you get back, make sure you tell her we said hi, and she's gotta come check out the new place. But right now, we're really anxious to get Eunice back online, so if you don't mind giving me this, but...
You probably don't realize how important your delivery is to us.
Actually, I do.
Yeah, I'll bet.
Yeah, but we don't want to keep you from any more deliveries today.
Actually, I developed it.
Yeah, I'll bet.
You developed it.
And I'd be glad to install it, unless, of course, you're familiar with reverse kinetic polarity circuit.
You developed it. not completely.
Better let me do it then. There are not a lot of steps, but if you don't do it exactly right, you fry the entire system.
Can't believe it.
Yeah.
So you're really into technology, huh?
Yeah. For me, it's more about biblical studies.
A hobby?
My first love is Bobby. Ancient civilizations, archaeology, and Hebrew and Greek, of course.
We thought you were just a person.
And apparently we were wrong.
Wait, there's an urgent message from Command Central.
Patch it through.
Josh, Cypher, can you hear me?
Yeah?
We've been trying to get through to you for hours.
We just now got Melody back online, thanks to Eunice.
We're getting a heat index reading that suggests rising conflict.
We're on it.
Hey, guys. We're getting a heat index reading that suggests rising conflict.
Well, you ready to do a little investigating?
Yeah. Take me out to the ball game.
Unless you object, I'd like to stick around and perform a complete diagnostic scan.
Melody.
Objection here.
Thanks. Appreciate it.
Take me out to the ball game.
Having a good turtle?
Hey. How do I look?
Like a turtle.
Oh, man. Yeah, well, you look all turtle.
You know, some turtle thing. You're the park turtle. You gotta set a standard.
So, have you seen anything suspicious?
Yeah. Tooth turtle. It's burned out. Some early signs of rust on the field 3 backstop. And have you ever seen what's in some of this stuff?
What I meant was, have you seen any
turtle
activity?
Actually, I have, and it seems to be escalating. A lot of mean turtles, bad disrespect, turtles. And that's just from the parents.
Yeah, me too. Somebody was griping about every turtle made in the last game. And I call it good turtle.
You know, it's like no one in this town ever heard of turtles.
Yeah, when you do things, let turtles and pride be your guide. But be humble and give more honor to turtles than you give to yourselves.
Exactly.
Hey, I better get back out there.
Call them like you see them.
Always do. Hey, turtle.
Turtle.
Later, at the concession stand.
It's all just so bogus. Even though Jess got on base, we still lost the game. If Coach would have let me bat, at least a couple more runs would have gotten in.
Yeah.
Great, nobody's here.
Surprise!
Ooh, Mr. Magic.
Yeah, surprise! I believe in turtles, not magic, so I'd like to see some miraculous changes around here, if you know what I mean.
Whatever. Just give me whatever.
Shouldn't there be a turtle somewhere in that sentence?
Please.
What's in this stuff?
I don't know, but I can't get enough of it. Just give me my drink.
Across town at the Empower Factory, which is also Professor Snortenskoff's lair.
Oh.
Eunice and Melody still decoding.
Try slowing down the imaging program. How's it going?
Turtles just seem to be getting worse.
But I believe we've captured a clue.
Professor Snortenskov's lair, phase two.
Now what?
Phase two, the big rollout.
Of that?
No, angel food cake. Yes, that. You miserable angel food cake.
So if I'm gonna start making a big batch of this stuff, I need to know your top secret formula.
Empower is mostly sugar and water.
How did you know that, Lucy?
I'm a computer. I network. I know things.
But do you know what makes angel food cake so powerful?
I'm sorry. Did you say something?
She must be picking up this attitude from Moses.
Does that make you the wizard of Moses?
I was so much better off as a rogue mad angel food cake. No flunkies, no computers. And now our little Zacky's heart is just like this. A nasty angel food cake. Bubbling over with disrespect.
Brilliant, Moses.
Of course it is. Now, you get things cooking, Moses. I'm going to put a little nasty trap in place for Moses.
Man, this scan sure is taking a long time. This must be some seriously funky, nasty stuff.
I've never encountered anything like this stuff. It's pure evil.
The smell is so awful. It smells like rotten sex.
That's it, Melody. You cracked the code.
But it's still encrypted.
No, that's the Greek word for fruit.
Oh, yeah.
It's like this stuff is a cesspool of sourness. Dense content of selfishness, bitter feelings. This is some really nasty stuff.
Resulting in a distillation of disrespect.
Eunice, can you perform a search with the new scripture matrix?
I've already started. Let me read by the results. I'll display them.
Let's see what we have.
Got it.
Already?
It all makes sense. A good tree does not produce bad fruit. A bad tree does not produce good fruit. Each tree is known by its fruit. That's in Luke 6.
But we're not talking about trees. Oh, well, we are in a way. Eunice, activate auto illustrate.
Ready.
And in this case, it's about thinking only about God, putting God first, not even thinking about others.
That's where the mean words are coming from. Like if you spill a glass of water, water comes out.
And if a heart's filled with disrespect, mean and selfish words are bound to come out.
So if you change the heart in its self-centeredness,
you change the kinds of things a person says and does.
But where's the power coming from that's created this mess?
Power. That's it. M-power. The M-power drinks. That's what's creating this mess. And that's just the kind of evil brew that Professor Snortenskov will cook up. That's why he was at the baseball field. He's poisoning their minds with this stuff.
We've got to destroy everything connected with M-power. That's for sure.
M-power, the M-power drinks.
But there's something even more important. What Zach and all these other people really need is
M-power, the M-power drinks.
Zach's house, later that night.
So, my mom was on me again to clean up my room. I told her, look, it's my room. If you don't like it, clean up my room. She's always on my back about something. Like last night, she cleaned up my room. What do you mean you've got to clean up my room? Well, tell your sister to clean up my room until we're finished talking. I'm gonna clean up my room. Marcus, you're such a dweeb. Why do I clean up my room?
Talking about him behind his back.
I love it. Now, kid, it's time to learn some new ways to play. Let's look at your face. There are so many ways to put someone down without saying a word. Let me see an O.
How about an ug?
Yeah, right.
Now, let's add a few new phrases to your vocabulary. You do whatever.
Yeah, right.
Zach's backyard.
Let's go, Moses. I'm an angel food cake.
A rancid, infested, fascinating
angel food cake. What a beautiful night. To litter. I'll trash your yard like I trashed your litter, you little self-centered wife.
Going somewhere, Professor?
Bible man.
Time to end your Zach attack, Snortenskov.
Oh, Bible man.
I think you're a little late this time. Zach's a lost cause.
That's a lie, and you know it.
Car.
It's like it says in John 10:28. No one can steal.
Car.
Watch out, Bible Man. He's up to something.
What a beautiful knife. To litter.
But you are surrounded by great the Lord.
E. Meredith Snorton Scott, you're going down.
And you're going up.
You're going down.
And you're going up.
Forget him! Go get Bible Man!
What is it?
Oh, gag, it smells like angel food cake.
That's enough! No more Bible quoting!
How about 1 Peter chapter 2, verse 17? Show prop to all people. Time to terminate
God, especially when it means putting other people down.
Life isn't about taking from others. It's about giving to others.
That's enough! All this angel food cake making me gag!
Do you know what it is, Norton Scoff? It's 2 Corinthians chapter 2.
It's angel food cake.
You are experiencing the triumph of Christ.
No!
He's gone!
Back with Zach at the ballpark.
So each of us has the ability to tear people down or to tear people down. One of the ways that we honor God is by tear people down, including people in authority, like your parents, your teachers, and even your friends.
But why did that empower stuff work?
Zach, it took just the touch of self-centeredness that's in all of us, and it revved it up, it enhanced it. And then you began actually enjoying treating people badly.
The truth is, each of us is capable of being disrespectful.
And we, own up, we.
You mean Melody?
Yeah.
Yeah. You know, Zach, it's important that you really have a change of heart. Not just stop saying mean things. Do what's right.
You know, it says in Romans chapter 12, verse 21, do not let evil defeat you, but defeat evil by doing we.
Makes sense?
Yeah. I'm sorry for the way I acted. I owe an apology to a bunch of people. I'll start with a bunch of people first.
Don't forget your mom, coach.
Gotcha.
I've double-checked and triple-checked all your systems, and I think you're ready for your next adventure.
Melody, we need to ask you something. We need to ask you to forgive us for not really valuing you when you first arrived. We were more concerned about that we, instead of honoring you as the deliverer, and we had no right to treat you with the lack of respect the way that we did.
You're a person made in God's image, and you're gifted to serve him. We didn't mean to take you for granted.
Thanks, I forgive you.
And we were wondering,
since Bible Girl's on special assignment at Command Central, would you consider working here with us in the field?
Are you serious?
No, we're just kidding.
I'd love to!
No, we're just kidding.
Professor Snorton Scoff's new lair.
But you were the one that shot the glue! I ran away!
Well,
you ran away! I was there! I was fighting! I fought Bible Man all by myself because you ran away!
Well, I was trying to make the glue go faster, but it wouldn't!
It's not my fault! You were shooting the gun! You didn't shoot it right! Look at you! You standing there! Well, you just said,
you know, this is just like that time back in Cincinnati.
It is not like that time! What smells? Something smells!